If you observe here, this particular code, it prints the numbers from 1 to 5, right? So if I just compile this code and run it, this prints 1 to 5 using this while loop, right? And if you observe here, this time I have used this compound assignment. You can even use your increment operator, right? So instead of this even, you can use i++. This is standalone. That means either you write like this i++ or you write i+= 1. Both have same meaning, right? From the working point of view. Anyways, if you focus, this code produces the result 1 to 5. Now this same code that you are seeing here, we can write using something called for loop. So we'll focus on that part now. So let me just comment out this thing. So with the help of for loop, we'll try to do the same thing, that is printing 1 to 5. So let me tell you the basic syntax for that. First of all, we use the for keyword, then parenthesis. First we write the first expression here, expression 1, then we write the second expression here, and the third expression, expression 3, we write here. And then this is the starting of the for loop and this is the ending of the for loop. So generally this first expression is your initialization statement, right? That means assignments are done here. Generally we write variables, we initialize variables in this expression 1. Expression 2 is your conditional expression, means any expression which results in true or false. And expression 3 is your update part, that means we update the part. So let me write the code, then this will become crystal clear to you. So in this case also, I'll be printing the numbers from 1 to 5. So I'll be writing here int i=1, and then i < 5, and here I'll be writing i++. And let me just generate the printing result, that is with the help of cout I'll print the value of i followed by new line. So if I save this code and if I compile it, you're going to get the same output, that is 1 2 3 4 5. So let's try to analyze this part. Okay, what is happening here? So if you just take this, okay, let me take this entire part along with the while. So from line number 7, I'll take it till line number 17 so that you can understand it clearly, right? So first of all we'll focus in this part, that is your line number 7 to 10. In this part we'll focus how it is working. So this is your initialization. So what happens, first of all, your value I is starting with 1, right? That's why it's called initialization. So for simplicity, I'll take it 3 here so that it is easy for me to explain. Okay. Now this is your second expression, that is expression 2, and this is the update part, that is your expression, third expression, right? And this is the body of the for loop. Right. So first of all, we use the for keyword, then within parenthesis we write the first expression, then this semicolon is mandatory, right? If you don't give it, then you are going to get error. These two semicolons are mandatory in for loop. Okay. Anyways, so make sure you don't skip this, otherwise you are going to get error. So let us try to understand that how it is working, right? So I starts from value 1, right? So let me write it little clearly here. So I starts from the value 1. All right. So what happens now after this? After this initialization, then condition will be checked, that is whether I is less than equal to 3 or not. So instead of 5, I have made it 3 so that it is easy for us. Now this condition is true, and a loop will allow to enter the body only if the condition is true. So this entire expression, that is i < 3 or 5, whatever you like to say, this turns out to be true. So we enter this part, and when this line number 9 is executed, so what happens, the variable I gets printed, right, for the first time. So the value of I is now 1, so 1 gets printed on the screen. After that what happens, after this line, your this update part is executed. That means the value of I is, so due to this i++, what happens, the value 1 gets converted to 2 because it is increment by 1, right? Now the value of I is 2, So again, now this part, if you see this initialization part, this part will be skipped now for the second time, and now we'll check the condition, right? Just like how in while it was happening, right? In initialization was only for the first time, if you remember, right? After we enter the body for the first time, then we check the condition. We don't go to this line number 12, right? We go to the condition. In the similar way, we'll go to the condition here, right? So now we'll check again whether 2 is less than 3 or not. So we know that this is true, right? And therefore 2 is going to be printed. In the similar way, 3 will also get printed. For 3 also it is true. The moment your value of I is going to convert into 4, so in this case, in the case of 4, what happens? When your value of I becomes 4, that time the condition becomes false, and as a result, because this condition became false, it will directly jump to this part, that is your in this line number 11. If let us say any code is there, at this part it will jump. So if you observe here, the for loop and while loop works exactly the same. It is just matter of style, that how you want to write your loop, right? So we can even write the for loop just like while loop. So if you observe here one thing, these three parts, that is your initialization part, condition part, and this update part, all are optional. So if I just omit all these three area, this will turn out to be infinite loop. What is an infinite loop? A loop which just keeps on executing, right? Because condition never becomes false. Anyways, so if I don't write any condition here or any expression here, it is taken for granted that it is true, and it will execute it again and again. So just like this while loop, I can use this for loop as well, right? So I'll be writing here the initialization statement, that is int I equals 1, and I will skip the first part because all these three parts are optional. In this middle of this two semicolon, I'll be writing the conditioner, that is I less than equal to, let's say, 3. And here, after the line gets executed, I will increase the value of I by 1, increment the value by 1. So now if I compile it and run it, you see, it works fine. So if you observe now, that is this line number 7 to 12 and this particular code, it is exactly the same. That is, instead of while, this for keyword is here, and this condition is written exactly same. Instead of 5, 3 is written, anyways that doesn't matter, and we have written here the semicolon, right? So it is exactly working like this while loop. So it is just up to you that which style you want to take. So sometimes writing the loop like this is very much succinct and very much clear, right? So that's why we often use this for loop. This is a very elegant way of writing the loops, right? So both the loops can be used interchangeably, there is no issue in that. So it is just up to you that what is more comfortable for you, right? So depending on that, you can use any loop that you want. So this is how your for loop is working, right? So let me write some more code here. Now let me try to write the code in such a way so that it prints the number in backward order. So in that case, I will start the variable from, let's say, 5, and then I'll just check that whether the number is greater than 1, and I will decrement, because 5, 4, 3, I want to go back step, right? That's why I minus minus, and finally I'll print out the value of I. Anyways, this was not required, but still let me tell you, if I just save the code and compile and run it, you'll see that you will get the output as 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So just try to think about it, that how it is working now. I hope that this for loop concept is clear to you. See you in the next session.